All right, good evening, everyone. Is everybody ready to have a real good time?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's indeed a pleasure for me to be here, and an honor for me to introduce someone who I consider one of the world's greatest living comics. And I won't stand up here and pontificate about him or tell all kinds of silly jokes myself. I will let the man himself come up here and entertain you. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce the one and only, the Mr. Martling, Jackie the Joke Man Martling. Wow.
What an introduction. What an introduction. Now go get dressed.
Yeah.
Hey, everybody, how's everybody doing? All right, hey? All right. We have got a stellar show tonight. We're videotaping, so you'll be caught on tape for the rest of your life. This will be on the internet. You'll be a fool for as long as you're alive, and long after you're dead. This is a very simple show. It's a very weird show. It's an experimental show. Everybody plays. Everybody tells jokes. I tell jokes. I tell lots of jokes. We spin the wheel. A concept comes up. You got a joke on it. You come up and tell a joke. You get $5. You tell any joke. You get $5. If you want, don't have a joke, you want to come up and read a joke. I have jokes. I'm going to give you a quick demonstration. All right, spin the wheel. All right, Polish. Polish family sitting in the living room. The wife turns to her husband and says, let's send the kids out back to P-L-A-Y so we can fuck. All right, midget. Why do midgets giggle when they run through a field? Because the grass tickles their ball. Now, if you don't have a joke at random, you get a joke. Totally at random. This is not magic. I'm not Penn and Teller. Let's see what this is. A guy's in the back seat with his date, and he puts in his finger. She says, put in another finger. He says, what do you want to do, whistle? Now, I've been telling jokes, but look at it. Here's the money. Lots of fives, lots of fives. You can win five, you can win 10. That's it. You can only break even on the show. You can't make money, okay? We'll start out with a nice visual joke. This is what I consider the world's funniest, cleanest, silliest joke that I've ever heard, and I will share it with you. I know the end. Two blondes are out to lunch, and the first blonde says to the second blonde, you got something on your cheek. The other blonde goes like this. She says, nah, the other side. She goes, oh, I'm sorry. Make sure your hands are clean. Here's one from 1955. I never got sick of this. A little old lady gets on a bus. She goes like this. Driver goes like this. She goes like this. He goes like this. She goes like this. He goes like this. She goes like this. Guy in the front says, who's that? Driver says, oh, the lady's a little hard of hearing, so we communicate visually. She said, you're going downtown? I said, uptown. She said, you're going to stop? I said, it's express. She said, you're going by the dairy farm? I said, the ballpark. She said, shit, I'm on the wrong bus. I've been telling jokes my entire life. That's all you have. Most comics, there's two things you don't do if you want to be a comedian. You don't tell old jokes, and you don't laugh at your own jokes. That's all I do. I tell old jokes and I laugh at them. I still find them very funny. I just go crazy. In third grade, I was in a friend's house after a snowball fight. And it was a little town, so it was guys, you know, third grader, second grader, fifth grader. And my cousin came in who was in eighth grade, which is, whoa! He took out a piece of paper and he read a joke, a dirty joke. And I looked around, I swear to you, as I'm talking now, I could still see their faces. They were spellbound. And I remember thinking, wow, that's cool. But I don't know if I thought cool, neat, whatever you think of 1955 in third grade. It was just like, wow. And it stuck with me. And since then, I've remembered every joke I've ever heard. Clean, dirty, I just remember them. That's the only thing I know. I was married 20 years. I used to say to my wife, what's your mother's phone number? She said, we've been married 20 years. You know 10 billion jokes. You can't remember 7 digits of my mother's number? And I couldn't tell her, well, your mother's phone number won't get me laid. But I really did. I graduated from college as a mechanical engineer in 1971, and I used my diploma to roll pot, okay? All I care about is jokes, just silly jokes. Now I would like to get you people going. Would anybody like to volunteer and come up and tell the first joke? Who would like to be first? Who would like to come up? Come on, my friend. Look at this. I guess you didn't jog here, did you? No. What is your name?
I'm Cameron Johnson.
Cameron Johnson. Nice to meet you, Cameron Johnson. Where are you from, Cameron?
I'm from Indianapolis, but I moved here like about a week ago.
A week ago? Welcome. Did you move here specifically to come up here and tell a joke?
Okay. Just for this moment.
Now, hold on, Cameron. I don't want to make you nervous.
Okay.
That could be yours, buddy. Go ahead. Go ahead, Cameron. The camera's on.
Okay.
Cameron. The camera's on.
All right.
Hold on. Let's do that a while. The camera's on. Camera's on. Cameron.
Thank you.
Don't be nervous.
I'm not.
Okay. I am.
You
got bigger tits than my girlfriend.
And I got them done.
Good job.
Okay, this joke was inspired. I just saw two words on there, and I came up with a joke while I was sitting down there.
Excellent.
So I saw midget and lawyer, and I thought, why are there less midgets in the legal system these days?
Why is that?
Why?
Because law school started raising the bar.
Oh. Like I said, Cameron, this could have been yours. Stay right there. At random. Go ahead, reach in and take one. If it's that same joke, I'll shit. No, don't go deep. Don't go deep. Stay near the top because down below they're too long.
Okay, there we go.
Oh, you know what? At random, I found this in my notes. No, I was going through my jokes and I've taken it on my radio show on Sirius. I put everybody's name in the jokes. You know, everybody's name that I know. So it would be, you know, Smith walked in a bar, Schneider walked in a bar, Ludwig walked in, all these people that are my friends because it was fun to say their names on the radio. But for this show, it didn't make any sense. Plus, people have so much trouble pronouncing names. So I made it the guy, the girl, the guy goes in, the girl. But then I came across this one. And we have a special guest in the audience tonight. So I left this the way it is. So you will read this, and then this. No, you want you read that one to warm up.
Okay,
are you ready?
Yeah.
The camera's on.
Okay, thank you. A couple's in bed. The husband says, how about it? She says, not tonight. I have to go to the gynecologist tomorrow, and I want to be fresh. He says, you're not going to the dentist, are you?
All right. You're getting $5, but you gotta read this one. Nice and slow.
Okay.
Miss
Pass Coochie walks into an eye clinic and puts a big jar on the receptionist desk. In the jars, a huge turd, 14 inches long and 5 inches around. She says to the receptionist, I need to see
an optometrist! How the fuck are you gonna make it in New York City? It's 3 syllables, you asshole! Optometrist, that can't be a showstopper! That's a fairly regular word. That's a guy that thinks good things about everything. Wait, start from the beginning! Take your hand off the mic. It looks pornographic.
Okay.
Big enough. It's bad enough you got big tits.
You
don't
say got big tits.
Okay, so. Hold on. Put that there.
Try to just complete
the
package.
Hand down. One hand down. Okay. Well, no. Hold on with one. Oh, yeah, hold on with two hands. We have the Arctic in here.
Okay.
Nice and slow. Now, everybody, pay attention to camera.
Miss Pascucci walks into an eye clinic and puts a big jar on the receptionist's desk. In the jar is a huge turd, 14 inches long and 5 inches around. She says to the receptionist, I need to see an optometrist. She says, ma'am, Looking at the specimen in that jar, I'd say you need to see a proctologist, not an optometrist. Miss Pascucci says, no, I need to see an optometrist. Every time I take a shit, my eyes water.
Good job! Give a round of applause! We'll be back later for when we go topless. Okay, I'm going to spin this wheel. If anybody's got a joke on the subject, I'm going to make it $10. $10 big dollars. You break even for the night. Here it is. Italian. Come on. Who's got an Italian joke? Right there. Step on up.
Oh, my God.
Deetzy. Oh, is that my? I'm Michael. I thought that was you over here.
I'm not gonna. It's more of a Polish joke, but there's Italian in it.
I'm not gonna blow your cover, Michael, until after the joke. Then I'll tell him who you are. Well, this is Donald Trump's son. Good. If you do a bad job, you have to read one. You might have to read one anyway.
All right. So again, it's more of a Polish joke. I'm Polish.
I told you not to let the fucking good-looking guys in, you asshole.
Sorry.
All right. All right, this is Mike.
All right, so there's three guys about to get locked in prison for 20 years. Japanese guy, Italian guy, and a Polish guy. They go to the Japanese guy, they say, what do you want to get one thing before we lock you in? He says, I want all the books I can read. They give him all the books, lock him away, turn the key. Italian guy, what do you want? All I want is my wife, just my wife. They give him his wife, they lock the door, turn the key. They go to the Polish guy, what do you want? All I want is all the cigarettes I can smoke. They put all the cigarettes in and lock the door. 20 years later, they unlock the Japanese guy's cell. He comes out, smartest guy in the world. The guy fucking learned everything. He's an attorney, he could be a doctor, whatever. He knows everything about everything. They go to the Italian guy's cell, they open it up. Kids, family, he's got 5 kids, full family, fucking great. They go to the Polish guy's cell, they open it up. He comes running out. Anybody have a fucking light?
I'm going to tell you where I heard that joke. I met this very cute waitress in 1975 at a place called Rum Runner, Joanne, in Oyster Bay. And she became my wife. And I heard that joke.
Really?
Yep. Anybody got a match? Yeah. There's your $5. Wait, you're not done? You're not done? If you screw this up, we take your $5 back. Okay? Here we go. I'll give you 2 short ones.
All right.
I did that last night.
This one?
Okay, one at a time. Wait for the laugh. Right.
You ready?
Yep.
Couples in the living room. He says, you're dry tonight. She says, you're licking the rug.
That's a pretty dirty one, Mickey. That's a dirty one you picked out.
All right.
Go ahead.
Ready?
Yep.
A guy goes into a library and says to the librarian, I need a book on suicide. The librarian says, fuck you, you won't bring it back.
Good job, dude! Good job! Good job! You might remember Michael from Beverly Hills 90210, right there. He was on the episodes I was on, so you probably don't remember him. Okay, who said, no, you just played.
I would, but I can't be on TV.
The cameraman's not even going to see this fucking video, you moron. There's no film in there. Come on up. Come on. Come on, don't worry. You're not going to get seen by anybody. Come on. You're not going to get seen by anybody except these 4 people. Come on. Stop it. Fucking Jews. Get up here. You know why Hitler didn't drink vodka? It made him mean. Come on. I can't remember his name. Tell me the doctor's name. Shecky. Nobody's going to see it.
Okay, turn off the recording.
No. Sit.
I got one right here.
Sit right there.
He'll only read one, though. He won't tell one. He'll read it.
Come on up.
Come on, go. Al, you read.
No, I can't read.
All right, we're not going to play it. Come on. Right there. Come on. You'll read one?
I'll read one. I can't. I don't
know. Hold on a second. Is it okay if you're on tape?
I guess so.
This is my favorite new joke, and I always perform it myself. But I'm going to give it to you because you're such a good guy for coming up. What is your name?
Norm.
Norm?
Yeah.
That's one of the most three famous Jewish men in the entire world. You see him in every car since 1957. Hi, Norm and Max.
Ouch.
Ouch. Oh. Oh. Every air conditioner. Oh. Say, hi, Norm, and Max. Which one were you?
Norm.
Norm. Is it me or did he have to think about it? All right, Max.
Should I read it?
No, just fucking stand there. Wait, into the microphone. Into the microphone. What do you do for a living? What do you do for a living?
Systems analyst.
Systems analyst. What do you think of this system?
Lousy.
Lousy? Fucking Jews. I don't care, fucking Jews. You could be wearing a burqa and I'd say fucking Jews. I learned that word today. Who told us that story? Everybody told me I was lying. My friends told me that Giselle Bundchen, Bundchen got a boob job and then walked out of the French hospital wearing a burqa as a disguise, but it's against the law to wear that, so she got arrested not just for being stupid, but for having on a burqa. Nobody gave a fuck that she was a famous model. She was wearing a burqa.
It was heat-inflate.
It was what?
It was inflate instead of deflate.
It was inflate instead of deflate. I have no idea what the... Here we go. Here comes high. Max.
Guy says to his wife, give me a blowjob. She says, be more romantic. He says, give me a blowjob in the rain.
That was good. Yes, you're getting $5. If you tell us when you get $5. Nice and slow, Maxie.
The trucker goes into a whorehouse, hands the madam $500, and says, I want your ugliest woman and a bologna sandwich. The madam says, for that kind of money, you could have one of my finest girls in surf and turf. The trucker says, I ain't horny, I'm homesick.
Here, let me autograph it. Thank you, Maxie. All right, give a round of applause. Come on. How about you folks? You got a joke? You got a joke, you mother... Okay. $10. $10. $10. Chinese or Japanese? Chinese or Japanese? No! He's saving up for more implants.
No. Wait, does it have to be a Jackie joke, or is it...
No, not a Jackie. Any joke in the world. Any joke in the world. Japanese, a Japanese joke, a Chinese joke, I don't care. It's from my CD, it's from the world. My jokes are not my jokes, they're from all over. You got a joke on a Japanese or a Chinese, just come up now.
There we go.
Now, why can't you people all dress like this? Look at this. Look at that. Look at that. Good handshake. Are you a politician?
No.
Now? You're going to make some girl's life real fucking long. What's 14 inches long and hangs in front of an asshole? Donald Trump's tie. Look at that handshake. I'm voting for you, even if you're not running.
I appreciate it.
What is your name?
Steven.
Steven, what do you do, Steven?
I'm an investment guy.
You're an investment guy?
Yeah.
You came right from work?
Yeah.
Oh, good. You married?
Yeah.
Is she here?
No.
Let's go fuck somebody. We'll go out with Michael and we'll be fucking everything we say. The truth is, we'll probably wind up fucking Cameron. Okay, Steve. See, I can't call you Max or High or Norm. That was a fun one. Where are you from?
Chicago.
From? It's a wonderful town.
Yeah, it is a wonderful town.
Very windy.
I heard that.
Very, very windy.
Steve. How windy is it?
How windy is it? One day the wind stopped and everybody fell down. You just don't get to use that much. Except I used it last week. And I thought, wow, what if there's repeat people here? And then I thought, wait a minute. I remember the show from last week. Nobody came back.
I never do.
All right, Steve Gard, investment banker.
All right, Chinese, Japanese, right?
One or the other, or both.
No, I only got one.
Korean is fine. Korean would be fine.
So you got three guys who are stranded on an island in World War II. They're stranded. It's an American guy, a German guy, and a Japanese guy. And they realize they're surrounded and they got to figure out a way to live. So the American guy says to the German guy, you got to be in charge of logistics. You got to get things coming in. You got to set up security for us. I am going to be in charge of security. I'm going to look around, make sure no one comes in here. Says the Japanese guy, you're in charge of supplies. So the American guy and the German guy go out, and the German guy is starting to work on logistics and how to get things from here to there, and the American guy's got a security perimeter set up, and they realize the Japanese guy's gone. They can't find him anywhere. The sun's starting to come down, so they go looking for him. And they're looking around, and all of a sudden they walk past a rock, and the Japanese guy jumps out, and he says, supplies!
Now that's a great joke, except you're making fun of the way they talk. My favorite Japanese joke, I tell this at every golf outing, it's a very funny story about it, and you can stand right there because you look pretty good. This American businessman's over in Japan, and the Japanese guys, you know, like this guy, they want to do business with him, and they send him upstairs with a Japanese hooker, and he starts banging her, and she goes, oh, Natsukayaina! He's like, yeah. She goes, Natsukayaina! He goes, oh, Natsukayaina! Natsukayaina! Next morning, the American's playing golf with the Japanese businessman. The American steps up to the tee and slices the ball way off to the right. And when the Japanese guy goes, oh, Natsukayaina! He says, what's that mean? He says, oh, wrong hole. Now, the great story, I was playing a golf outing, and I tell that joke like on the first or second hole every time because it's funny and we're having fun. So I tell that joke and we're laughing. So as we're playing the round of golf, every time somebody hits a lousy shot, one of the guys, of course, oh, Natsukayaina. So all of a sudden we come to one of these holes where the girls are sitting there to see if you get a hole in one. There's four pretty girls. I said, well, you don't need four. You, get in the cart with us, we'll have some fun. So the girl gets in the cart with us, and she's from Dallas, Texas. Nice Dallas, Texas girl. And you know, somebody hits her, oh, Natsukayaina! Oh, Natsukayaina! Finally say, hey, listen, Christy, let me tell you. I gotta tell you, that's a joke. The reason we're laughing is like a little inside, and I told the joke, and she laughed really hard. And after she got done laughing, she said, I'm glad you cleared that up. I thought that was one of them there Yiddish expressions. Yiddish. All right. You look so nice. Here's a horrible one. Here's Steve from Chicago, investment banker.
Kid says, Pop, can I have $20 for a blowjob? Father says, I don't know, son. You any good?
Did I give you money?
No.
No money?
I'm in the business. I'll take your money sooner or later.
Do you have that CD?
I do not have
You
that
still
one.
Don't have that CD. Now, here you go, Steve. Good, good.
Thanks, Jack.
Thanks, Mike. Get a round of applause. How great was he? How great was he? Why did Disney World fail in Japan? Nobody was tall enough to go on the good ride. You can't go past the Chinese and Japanese. You see, you don't want to waste the category. And then if it comes up again, then we're stuck, Cameron. What are we going to do? We're going to have to call you back. You'll be emergency. Okay? Chinese couple's in bed. And the husband says, I want a 69. His wife says, why you want beef and broccoli now? Confucius, eh? schoolboy who fool around with schoolgirl during wrong period get caught red-handed. How'd the Polish girl burn herself on the 4th of July? She lit the fuse to her tampon. Who's got a joke? Who's got a joke? Spin the wheel. Who's got a joke in the back row? In the back row?
Yeah.
Anybody? Right there. Don't raise your hand. I can't see. Come on. Come on. Here we go. Here we go. We got a volunteer. We got a volunteer. I see a shining thing coming forward. Well, I remember you. You were here before, and you were very good.
I'm a recidivist.
You're a lawyer. Okay.
All right.
Tell them your name, what you do, and your penis size.
I'm Jim, the lawyer. I'm Irish, so therefore, well, let me tell you a story.
Ask me how big I am.
Jackie, how big is your dick?
4 inches.
4 inches?
Yeah, it's a little too wide for a lot of women. Smart people, not to blow my own horn. Who the fuck am I, Ron Jeremy?
It is you.
I was having dinner with a bunch of friends the other night, and Ron Jeremy called me. I said, I just got a phone call. I said, I'll blow anybody can tell me who just called. I said, Ron Jeremy called me, but while I'm eating. I mean, please. But what are we talking about?
Your dick size.
Oh. The smart people love jokes. They just do, because they're little problems. They have a beginning and middle. Like it's a given and fine, like geometry, trigonometry. Smart people like jokes. Some of these stupid people don't laugh as hard at jokes. You know, you get a smart audience, they laugh at these stupid things because they meet you at the punchline. Neil deGrasse Tyson is a huge joke teller. I haven't met him yet. And Noah Chomsky, the brilliance of the world rests in his head, except for the little hunk that's full of dick jokes, okay? So on the other night, I'm at this film festival, and these guys come on and say, Jackie, we love you, man. You know every joke. They were like 60, 65-year-old guys. Really old guys. Really old guys. He said, we love you. And one guy says, my grandfather was a very famous cantor, and one of his best friends was Albert Einstein. I never heard this before, and this is a true story. Albert Einstein was a huge dirty joke fan, which made total sense after finding about Chomsky and Neil deGrasse Tyson. But Albert Einstein's favorite joke was, my dick isn't that big, but I love every foot of it. I haven't Googled it yet because I'm so scared it's bullshit. All right, Jim, you're on your own here. Don't fold your hands. Looks like you're in court. Now you look like you're at a fucking wake.
Nearly departed.
Okay.
Anyway, my wedding night, you know, I was shy, I was a virgin, and I asked my wife if we could get undressed in the dark. She said, okay, sure. So we turned on the lights, we got undressed. I put it in her hand, and she said, no, thanks, I don't smoke.
I've got 6 CDs, 78 minutes each. And that's not even all my jokes. I got like 5 hours of jokes. And out of those 5 hours of jokes I have on CD, I have written 3 of them. And this cocksucker just told one of them. And he knew it. You know the jokes I follow it with?
I do not know.
Put it in a girl's hand, she said, Jackie, you know I don't get high. I had a very small cock. I have a very small cock. I was on the high school football team and the coach never played me, but he made me take a shower anyway. He said it was good for the team's morale. If I got circumcised again, I'd have a scab on my ass. I got to jerk myself out. Wait a minute, you're not done. You're a good guy. You're a good. Don't clap. Don't clap for him. Don't clap for this guy. Okay, hold on. Oh, here we go. Here we go. That's too dirty. That's too dirty.
Oh, no, it's not.
Here we go. This is perfect. This is perfect. Into the microphone. Into the microphone with tape recorder.
Yes, dear. Guy comes.
Hold on. Get a shot of this fucking guy. Not really, Ed. Not really. Who's got a mirror? All right, we having fun? Yeah, having fun, aren't you, Jim?
Time of my life. Guy comes home from work and finds his new bride sliding down the banister. Says, what are you doing? She says, warming up your dinner. This is Jackie.
Okay, last one. Then you're out of here. Last one, right into the microphone.
Guy goes up to a girl in a bar and says, hey, big time. What's on your agenda tonight? She says, I was going to fuck your brains out, but it looks like somebody beat me to it.
Sit down! Good job! Good job! Good job! Did you get your money?
Thank you.
Sit down. Who's got a joke? Right here. Who's got a joke for you? You did great. You did great. Hi, Max. Right here? Right here? Come on.
I have a joke.
All right. Come on up, honey. Sound like a girl. I hope it's a girl. Leave your drink over there. Leave your, Jesus Christ, it can't go 4 seconds.
Who told me to bring it?
Hi.
Hi.
You're very pretty for a girl.
Thanks.
What is your name?
Monique.
Unique?
Monique.
Unique Monique.
That's me.
You're a pretty girl.
Thanks.
Married?
Yes.
Is he here?
No. He's not even in town.
Not in town? How about that? Where are you from?
Here. Right around the corner.
Oh, he's not. He's out of town.
Yes, far out of town.
How far?
Colorado.
Any chance he's flying in tonight?
No, no chance.
Drop something, I'll push you to my room. I can't help but look at your outfit and wonder, I'm wondering if you just stood outside trying to decide which place in New York City you'd like to go tonight. Your shorts are so tight I can read your lips. I usually say that kidding around, but I happen to be serious.
You're fine.
If you had balls, we could count them. How are you doing?
Okay.
So you're married. He's out of town.
Yes.
Okay. You fool around?
No comment.
With her?
I don't know her, but exactly.
We can remedy that.
Okay.
Okay, those are very real chests. They're absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
I can't believe that fucking idiot would go out of town.
Well,
you don't
has
have to
work.
Prop them up. They're fine.
Somebody has to work in this family.
Okay, good. How long married?
10 years.
Wow. Do you know the difference between spit and swallow?
Yes, I do.
40 pounds of pressure. See? That's one of...
Yep. I hate you, Steve.
One of the,
I hate you.
One of the other three jokes I wrote in my life is why don't Jewish girls swallow?
I don't know.
They want to be the spitting images of their mothers. That's horrible. You make it. All right. Now, you got a joke or am I giving you one or both?
I have a joke.
All right. We're going to leave you all on your own. You got kids?
No.
Okay.
Okay, so
he refuses to flip you over, huh? That was an I agree with Jackie laugh.
I cannot believe I raised my hand.
Go ahead, go ahead.
So this little boy goes to school every day, and every day he passes a series of prostitutes. And every day the prostitutes look at the little boy, and one of them goes like this, "Hello, little boy." So this happens for a couple of days. Hello, little boy. Hello, little boy. Hello, little boy. Finally, he stops, and he goes up to this big Zoptic woman and says, why do you do that? Why are you saying hello to me and putting your pinky up like this? So she said, well, I'm saying hello to you, and I'm saying hello to your little peenie. She said, well, that's, he said, well, that's fine, but I don't walk past you and go, hello, lady.
Is it me, Unique, or was that a big vagina joke?
That's a big vagina joke.
Do you know that joke about the guy that sends his wife to the gynecologist? So she goes to the gynecologist, and the gynecologist has her up on steps, and he says, my God, that's the hugest vagina I have ever seen. That's a huge vagina. She goes, ah! So that night she gets home. Husband's not there yet. She takes a mirror, gets it down off, puts it there, and takes off all her clothes, and squats over it to have a look for herself. And she's just squatting and looking down when her husband walks in from work. He says, what are you doing? She says, I'm just exercising. He says, well, be careful not to fall in the hole. I'm not done. Guy, we have to tell a brothel joke.
Okay. Where's that hand
so
going?
So a guy. Hold on. Pretty close. Guy goes to brothel. He says, the madam, I want a girl with crabs. Get out, what do you mean? My girls don't have crabs, you're an idiot. We don't have crabs, get out of here. As he's walking out, one of the girls says, I'll do it with him. I'll tell him I got crabs. She goes out and says, hey, you, come on back. I got crabs, I'll do you. He comes back, and they go up in the room, and he fucks her. And when they get done, she feels a little guilty. She says, you know, I got to tell you, I don't have crabs. And the guy says, yes, you do. You gotta read one.
That's the nastiest one, yeah.
That's not that nasty, but perfect for you. Nice and slow, into the microphone.
I got this.
Nice and slow, take your time, we're looking at your chest. Okay. Wait. Smile to this, that's the close-up camera. Do you know that joke? Guy says to his friend, I was with a girl last night, she had the biggest pussy I've ever seen. She had a pussy like this. His friend says, that's not that big. He says, no, that's her asshole. This is a pussy. You'd be telling that later as soon as you get dressed.
I'm not getting dressed
tonight. I know. Okay. Quiet.
A kid's walking past his parents' bedroom.
You gotta go slower. These people haven't heard it. You gotta go nice and slow and be, you know, expressive.
A kid's walking past his parents' bedroom. The door's open. He looks in and he sees his father banging his mother. He says, what's going on, Papa? His father says, we're making babies. The next night, the kid's walking past his parents' bedroom. The door is open. He looks in and he sees his mother sucking on his father's cock. He says, what's going on, Mama? She says, the right answer. We're making jewelry.
$5 for each.
Thanks.
You need money. Good job, Monique. Good job. This is $10. You got a joke on this? $10. Oh, boy. The bad place. Anal sex. Who has an anal sex joke?
I don't.
You don't? Well, that's one down. Who has an anal sex joke? Anal sex joke.
I got it.
Yeah.
Go, Steve.
All right, Steve.
It's Gillo. Is it me, or is that exactly what you were wearing the last time I saw you 4 years ago?
Exactly.
Okay. This is Steve Gillo, formerly of the Howard Stern Show.
Hey,
right now. This is one of my favorite Jackie jokes.
We don't want to hear your fucking life story. Tell a joke.
It's my favorite Jackie joke of all time, and I'm going to try to do it.
Don't, just like Jackie joke, man.
Don't look at me. I know it. Tell her.
Girl's on the witness stand. And the judge says, I know this is really hard, but you're going to have to tell this jury what happened that night. And the judge said, please, just take your time. Tell the jury. She goes, okay. Everything was good. I was walking down the block, minding my own business. And this guy came out of nowhere, and he dragged me down this alley. He ripped off my dress, and he stuck it in my head. Oh, my God. I can't make it. I can't go on. I can't. And the judge goes, make something up. Make something up.
I don't even tell that on stage anymore. It's disgusting.
Give me my money, motherfucker.
Hold on. Hold on. Nice and slow.
Nice and slow.
Look at the beard. It looks like he went down on it and came up with it. Nice and slow. Nice and slow. Quiet. Take your hand. Come on.
Little Red Riding Hood's walking through the woods when the big man wolf jumps out and says, "Ah, I'm going to fuck you." She says, bullshit, you're gonna fuck me. You're gonna stick to the script and you're gonna eat me, you hairy bastard.
Here you go, Bill. Good job, good job. Hey, give him a round of applause. Come on, volunteers, who wasn't going? You, come on. Is that, do we know her? Come on, come on. Anything. He's still warming up. Anybody? Come on, volunteers. Come on. Volunteers right here? Come on, lady. Come on. I'll give you a come on, give her a round of applause. Come on, honey. Come on. I'll give you a nice, gentle one.
Okay. I'm prone for falling.
Are you ready? It's a nice outfit. Say hello to fucking Zorro for me. Your name is what?
Alexi.
Alexi?
Yes.
Hi.
Hi.
Sexy curly hair.
Yeah.
Is that your husband over there?
Yeah.
Yeah? How long?
8 years.
No, I mean, how big is this guy? He looks like a nice guy. You look like a nice girl. Is it all right if she reads this joke?
Of course.
Good. Okay, do you have a joke of your own you'd like to tell?
No.
You a little stoned? Can you fucking see me? A little stoned. A little stoned. You know when you're really stoned, you're sitting there picking away at the holiday turkey and it's still frozen.
I've been known to do that on occasion.
Okay, so you married 8 years?
Yes.
Okay. The same guy.
That one's my friend.
Which one's your friend?
This one.
Oh, Pascucci with the big turd?
That's right.
As long as I've known you forever, I never knew you could take a dump like that. They call it a spanner. You know what a spanner is?
No.
That's when you do a turd that's so big, it goes across the bowl, and when you flush, the water goes under it. So it's like, it's a bridge over the river shit.
Okay.
Okay, nice and quiet. Nice and quiet. Into the microphone.
Okay. A guy.
Tell him your name.
Alexi.
Where are you from?
New York.
And what do you do?
Currently a stay-at-home mom.
Okay. You breastfeeding?
No.
You wanna?
No.
All right, baby.
You can't get high and breastfeed, apparently.
Speak for your own damn self. Ron Jeremy gets stoned and sucks his own tits. Okay, into the microphone, nice and quiet.
Okay.
Nice and quiet.
A guy meets a girl in a bar. They go back to his place and she gives him an incredible blowjob. Then he's lying there smoking a joint and she starts stroking his cock. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, stroking his cock. Finally he says, "You like that, eh? You want some more?" She says, "No, I'm just admiring it because I used to have one of my own."
You on that joke. That's the dirtiest joke in there, and you loved it. You sat there like you're all shy, and you read that joke. You stay right there. You stay right there. You stay right there. Okay. Here's something nice and disgusting for you. Okay, this is not good. This is not good. Nice and quiet. What if you could have anything in the world besides me? What would you want? What would you besides? Don't give me that health for my children, all that crap. What would you want? I know different husband, but
a gorgeous apartment in Manhattan.
A glorious apartment.
A gorgeous apartment.
Oh, apartment
in Manhattan. Yeah.
Yeah. Where do you live?
In Stuyvesant Town, First Avenue, 16th Street.
You're moving, huh?
Not yet.
It's a nice place?
Yeah. My husband treats us well.
Okay. But you wish it was a little better.
A little more.
A little better. I'm not going to say, you know, you want to motivate him?
Okay.
Suck his cock. You can go to the psychiatrist till you're blue in the face. You can line him up and go to every Jew in Manhattan. Suck his cock, that guy will be shot out of a cannon. You'll be living in fucking Trump Tower. Make some jewelry. Fuck, suck my cock, I'll chip in. This can't be on tape. You cannot be captured on tape. Could you wear a t-shirt under your shirt? You want a blanket? Are you chilly? You got a fur hat. You want a fur hat? Go wrap your tits around his face. It's a rich doctor from Miami Beach. He'll buy you a condo. She's considering it. What's your husband? What's your husband's name?
Gabriel.
Gabriel?
Yes.
It's a very romantic name, Gabriel. Gabriel. Gabriel's horn.
Uh-huh.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You blow on it? Heard that joke in 51. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Nice and clear, slow, so they can digest.
A guy goes to the doctor and says, "Doc, I can't sleep, but I can't take pills either." The doctor says, "No problem. I'll put a sleeping pill in a suppository and you can take anally." The next day, the doctor calls the guy and says, "Did it work?" The guy says, "It worked too good. I woke up with my finger in my asshole."
You understand the key to the show is how fucking good the jokes are, right? Can you guess? Go give that to Gabriel. Gabriel, you want to come up equal time? Come on. Come on, Gabriel. Come on, Gabriel. Let's hear it for Gabriel. Okay. I know you want to impress your wife. I know you want to impress your wife. Thank you for playing the game.
I got my own.
You have your own joke?
I got one.
Why were you sitting there?
Well, I was waiting for her. It actually is a great segue.
Oh, you know what? You're absolutely right.
So.
Hold on. You understand that word, segue? There's not that many people here. I want to keep everybody up on it.
So.
Everybody up on it. Okay. If that's a wig, you deserve a refund.
So things weren't working out.
Tell them I know it.
And,
start from the beginning. Quiet.
So this guy's at his therapist, and he's talking about how things aren't going so well in the bedroom. And so I said to the therapist, I mean, this guy says to the therapist, give me some tips. So the sex therapist says, "All right, next time you get a Lexi in bed, next time you get the light in bed, try this. Just use, just think about currency, just think about nickel." So you say, "Nickel, nickel, nickel." So all right, I'm like, okay, that's a good tip.
That's a great idea.
So I go back home, get in bed, say, "Nickel, nickel, nickel." She's like, "Whoa, that is awesome." So I go back the next week, therapist says, "If that worked, try this one. Nickel time, nickel time, nickel time." So I go back home, Lexi's loving it. She's like, "Oh my God, where are you learning this stuff?" I'm keeping all these secrets to myself. Everything's going great. I go back to the sex therapist. She says, "Oh, That's working. You gotta do nickel, dime, quarter, nickel, dime, quarter, nickel, dime, quarter, nickel, dime. Oh, it's sex life is going great.
Unbelievable.
She's like, be careful, but try this one. Nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter. So I go home, got candles lit all over the room, set the mood, put on some Barry Manilow in the back.
Oh.
Nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime. She's like, oh my God, this is awesome. Nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime. She's like, this is, she's like ripping my hair out. Nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime. She's like, nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter, dot. Nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter, dot, nickel, dime, quarter, dot. It's like, fuck it, $1.40, $1.40, $1.40.
I heard that joke in 1966 from Jerry the Jew from Jersey at Michigan State University, who talked with a lisp. And I can still see him going, hit the penny, hit the nickel, hit the dime, hit the quarter. Hit the penny, nickel, hit the dime, hit the quarter. Penny, nickel, hit the dime, quarter. Fuck the small change. Good job, dude. Now you gotta read this one. Give a round of applause. That was great. $1.40. What do you do for a living?
I'm an attorney.
Attorney. And you can't buy her a decent fuck apartment? Yeah, he probably got a girl sitting in the next apartment. See, different one, right? Yeah, fucking attorney. You're not Jewish.
I'm not.
Yes, you are. No. I know he's not Jewish. Christ, if he was Jewish, you'd be living where you want. Quiet. What kind of attorney?
Sports.
Okay.
So guys.
So you go to a lot of games.
I go to some games.
Okay. Yeah.
So a guy goes up to a hooker and says, how much for a blowjob?
Now, see, you got to go slow because if somebody didn't hear the word hooker, the joke would be lost. That's like one of those, you got a certain words, you got to, if this was acting school, you'd be a line under hooker, so you hit, ow, hit hooker.
Guy goes up to a hooker.
Now you don't fucking overdo it, lawyer.
He says,
start over.
So a guy goes up to a hooker and says, how much for a blowjob? She says, $100. He says, okay. And he starts to jack off. She says, what are you doing? He says, for $100. You don't think I was gonna give you, you don't think I was gonna give you the easy.
Wait, whoa. Oh.
Where's the line on that one?
For $100, you don't think I was going to give you the easy one, did you? See, we have to read Jack Trump. It's going to take him forever to come, so he really enjoyed the blowjob, see? Don't question me. It's a fucking great joke. Now go deliver it like you're making money. From the beginning.
From the beginning?
Yeah. Where are we going to go? All
right.
You don't do that in court. Wow.
Guy goes up to a hooker and says...
Goes up to what?
A hooker.
Start over.
A prostitute.
A guy goes up to a hooker. Start over. That's a perfect take, and then we're going to go nuts at the end.
A guy goes up to a hooker, also known as a prostitute, and says, how much do you require for a blowjob? She says, $100. He says, okay, and he starts to masturbate. She says, what are you doing? And he says, for $100, you didn't think I was going to give you the easy one, did you?
That's a guy's joke. The other version of that joke is a guy picks up this beautiful girl with hair under her arms, but she's wearing something slinky, hair under her arms, but perfect body, she's really beautiful. He pulls over, and it's an Italian girl, and she says, you going to town? He says, yeah, I'm going to town, you know. And as she goes to get in the car, another guy jumps out. Guy jumps out with a gun, points it at the driver's head. He says, jerk off. He had a gun. He jerks off. He gets stunned. He says, jerk off again. Jerks off again. One more time. He jerks off again. The guy says, okay, now give my sister a ride to town. first lucky couple. Thank you, George Fenneman. Okay, here we go. This is for $10. $10. $10. $10. Jewish. Who got a Jewish joke? Who's got a Jewish joke? Who's got a Jewish joke? Somebody's up. Somebody's up. I have movement in the back. Come on forward. Okay. Oh, deja lawyer. Okay. You're on. We're not going to talk to you, Jimmy.
Good.
Moise, the accountant, has been embezzling from his company for years and years and years. And finally, he doesn't go in one day. They go over the books. They find he's been stealing millions of dollars from them. So he's convicted. They send him off to Lewisburg prison. He's processed. And then they send him off to his cell. And they close the door behind him, and he turns around. And his cellmate is this 6'10", 350-pound black guy. He's glowering down at Moish. And he says, "You and me is going to be playing house. Does you want us to play the husband, or does you want us to play the wife?" And Moish looks up at him. "But it's all the same with you, sir. I prefer to play the husband." He goes, "That's fine. Now get over here and suck your wife's dick."
That's so horrible. Sit down. Sit down. That's horrible. That's homosexual and that's racist. That's horrible. That's horrible. That's a great joke. Is what that is. Anybody in the back? Come on, come on. Get that quarterback. They never get old. The Jewish Santa Claus comes down the chimney and says, "Hey kids, you want to buy some toys?" Now here's a joke that's a little hip. A little hip. A little hip. A porn star moves to suburbia. And he's sitting on his front stoop smoking a joint. And his neighbor comes out. He says, "Where are you going?" His neighbor says, I got a blind date tonight. Porn star says, "Well, good luck." He says, "Thanks, man." A couple hours later, the guy comes back. He's walking up the steps. Porn star says, "How'd you do?" The guy says, "I only got the first base." And the porn star says, "Well, at least you got your asshole licked." You know why Jewish people watch porn movies backwards? They like the part where the hooker gives the money back. How can you tell the porn star at the gas station? Just as the gas is coming up the hose, he yanks out the nozzle and sprays the gas all over the windshield. It's a money shot, you asshole. I gotta read my own joke. I gotta read a joke myself. I'm gonna read it myself. The guy goes up to the drugstore counter and says to the girl behind the counter, "I need some condoms or I need some pesticide." And she says, "Don't you mean spermicide?" He says, "No, I mean pesticide. My wife's got a bug up her ass, I'm going in there." Oh, no, this is disgusting. I'll tell us one.
Who will tell it?
Oh, I'm gonna. Who's coming up? Come on, somebody. Come on, gang. Come on. Just the whole idea of the thing is to help. Come on. Come on. Here we go. Come on. Come on. Buddy Mantilla, look at this. We got celebrities.
Who's a celebrity?
You're a celebrity.
Get out of here.
You were a celebrity back when you were alive. Thanks to you, I stood there at Catch the Rising Star and went on at 4 in the morning instead of 1 o'clock because you fucking guys wouldn't shut up. The Fantastic Untouchables. Did I ever ask you if that was a true story about what? The Elephant Man?
Which one?
I'm going to tell you a story that involved you guys, and I never found out if it was bullshit, but if it's a lie, it's the greatest story I ever heard.
who's Marvin?
Braverman.
Braverman.
Right.
So one, two, or three of you guys and Martin Braverman.
No, three all together.
No, but I'm saying this is in the story.
Oh.
Somebody was missing. These guys are drunk and stoned, and they know everybody in show business, and it's the opening. It's the premiere. Don't correct me if I'm lying. It's the premiere of Elephant Man, the movie Elephant Man. Now, if you remember the Elephant Man, this fucking horrendous thing. He's an ungodly thing, and he gets adopted by this countess who loves him and wants to do everything she can for him, and she's going to take him to the theater, and she gets him a tuxedo, okay? And this is the premiere of the movie at the Ziegfeld, and everybody's there in tuxedos, dressed up. So not everybody, and these guys are in the back drunk, you know, picking their noses and being idiots. And it's quiet. And the countess gives the Elephant Man a tuxedo. She says, try it on, try it on. And this thing goes in the other room and puts on the tuxedo. He comes out the door, this thing in the tuxedo. And he says to the countess, how do I look? How do I look? And one of these guys in the back yells, the truth! Is that a true story? I love it. Buddy Man's here. Here he is. That was Marvin. The truth? That you look horrible, you fucking deformed.
We weren't stoned.
You weren't stoned. What? No. Not in those days. It was a long time ago. They hadn't invented pot back then.
How many more old jokes you want
to do? I'm not doing old jokes. I'm older than you. Come on, let's go.
Guy's sitting home reading the paper. His wife walks in and says, does this dress make me look fat? He says, no, you big ass bitch, you look fat. No.
Yes, he's married Tyler Moore.
I used to be, but I quit.
You quit. You're getting $5, now you're going for 10. Jesus. Look at those goggles. Let's go out and melt some ants.
You're going to make me come back.
Yeah, I hope.
Two flies land on a piece of shit. The first fly lifts his leg and the second fly says, come on, man, I'm trying to eat.
Okay, this is one more drunk joke. A drunk joke. This is for Rick Newman. Quiet on the set.
Two guys are sitting at a bar, both really drunk. Well, the first guy pulls down his zipper and starts pissing in his beer bottle. The second drunk says, what are you doing? The first drunk says, this shit's so good, I'm going to drink it again.
All right, $10. The good old days, Camp Fair. Thank you for being here.
I never saw this much money in my life.
Get out. DeBellis, are you coming up or what, DeBellis?
Yeah.
Come on, Johnny boy. I know. If Ventia's here, I know DeBellis is here.
How do you know?
Because I can smell you. God, is there anybody here that's not bald? This is John DeBellis. If you saw him in any of the Robin Williams movies, you're an asset. He was never in any of them. Tell him who you are and what you like.
I don't know. Nothing. I like you.
I like you too.
But not that way.
Okay.
I don't know what to do. I'm trying to think. An ugly joke, I guess. Right?
John does one-liners. He's famous for 40 years.
One-liners.
40 years. So do some one-liners.
One-liners.
Here's John.
One-liners. Okay. My girlfriend is so ugly, I don't know if I had anal or oral sex with her. When do most pedophiles wash their hands? When they're performing christenings.
You're up to 450.
Thanks, John. Small penis show?
Go.
The other night I was with my girlfriend, and She actually, she made me put on a condom. It was a perfect fit. And they didn't have to unroll it. She told me I was hung like a horse, a seahorse. Yeah, my penis is actually considered the shortest distance between two points. It's been referred to as an innie. Actually, I like having penis, small penis. This way I could masturbate in public. Actually, I had my penis enlarged. I was tired of peeing on my balls.
Give a round of applause! John was on that famous TV show, Make Me Laugh, and his claim to fame is he made Helen Keller laugh. Good job, DeBellis. Good job, Mantia. What's Helen Keller's favorite color?
Black.
A corduroy. How'd Helen Keller get hit by the car? She stopped to read the sewer cap. It's a little obscure. I almost didn't tell it, but I did. What did Helen, because I knew I had this one. What did Helen Keller say when she put down the cheese grater? That's the most violent book I ever read. Why can't Helen Keller drive? She's a woman. Here we go. Gail, this is you.
Gail.
Divorce.
Perfect.
Divorce? Who's got a divorce show? A guy's kneeling in front of a headstone. He's crying, he's going, if only you had lived! If only you had lived! And a gravedigger comes over and says, who's in there? Your wife? He says, no, my first wife's husband. Divorce. You know that the 95-year-old Jewish couple come in front of the judge? We want a divorce. He says, how old are you? She says, 95. He says, why are you coming before me at the age of 95? And she says, we wanted to wait till all the children were dead.
So I'm an investment guy, right?
Oh, we know.
Yeah, I know. What's the worst thing about a stock market downturn? I lose half my money, I'm still married.
Hold on. The best marriage joke ever. The wife says, get out, get the fuck out! And as the husband's walking out the door, she says, I hope you die a slow, painful death. He turns around and says, so now you want me to stay? All right, take
$5. All right, yeah, you owe me $5 for
I want a return on that. Okay, come on, somebody. What about that guy? Gross. Something gross.
I got a gross one.
Come on up.
All right.
Here we go. Here we go.
I got a gross one.
You got a gross one?
Yeah.
This is Tom. He's been in a deep freeze since Woodstock.
All right, there's three guys On a deserted island, they've been captured by cannibals. And so the first guy is a British guy, it's an American guy, there's a Mexican with him. So the British guy goes up first, and the tribe leader says, okay, we caught you here. Of course he's going, blah, 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 they don't know what he's saying. But he says, we caught you, so you got a choice between death and the aristocrats. So the gentleman says, you know what? I'll take the aristocrats. So the whole village comes out and they fuck him in the ass and they come on his face and they shit on him and they treat him like the piece of garbage and shit and everything and all that, and then they kill him. So they go to the next guy, and now this guy, he's shaking, you know, the other guy's peed himself already, he's ready to go. And they say, okay, so you have the choice between death and the aristocrats. And he looks at him and he says, I will take death. And then the leader says, yes, but first, the aristocrats.
If you didn't fuck that joke, nine ways to know if you got a great laugh, so take that. Have you? I'm going to give you a joke to read.
Oh, that would be great.
You'd be great?
Yeah,
we'll see. We'll see. Okay, this is in bad taste. This is in bad taste. We're getting that part of the night, bad taste. You're coming up, Pascucci. All right, Tommy.
A guy's got two daughters and he wants a son. His wife gets pregnant and she has a boy. He's so excited, he rushes to the hospital, into the maternity ward, and it's the ugliest baby he's ever seen. He says, this is crazy. I've got two beautiful daughters. He turns to his wife and says, have you been cheating on me? And she says, not this time.
Get out of here. Get out of here. Get out. Give a round of applause. Kids at the kitchen table. He says, Mom, gay. She says, does that mean you suck men's cocks? He says, yep. She says, don't ever complain about my cooking. Old couple's in the living room. The wife turns to her husband. She says, let's go upstairs and fuck! He says, I don't know if I could do both. Girl goes to the gynecologist. She says, Doc, I'm freaking out. I'm freaking out. I keep finding postage stamps from Costa Rica in my vagina. He examines his lady. Those aren't postage stamps. Those are the stickers from bananas. Did you hear about the new super sensitive condoms? Okay, after you fuck her, they stay and talk to her. Shooting at random because these are so much fun. Guy goes in the bar. This beautiful blonde barmaid. And behind her is a sign. Cheese sandwich, $5. Chicken sandwich, $7. Hand job, $50. He says, you the one that gives the hand jobs? She says, yep. He says, wash your hands, get me a cheese sandwich. If you don't think that was funny, I don't care about you. Couple goes to marriage counselor. Marriage counselor says, I think we should begin with something we have in common. The husband says, neither of us likes to suck cock. How the fuck could you not laugh at that? We're spinning a wheel. $10 if you have a joke on Old Faithful. $10, come on, take a shot, somebody, come on, you coming in?
What's Faithful?
What?
What's Faithful?
Oral sex.
Oh, I got one.
There we go, here we go.
All right, I got one.
Here's Mickey.
All right.
So there's a penguin Corvette. You can imagine that, right? Driving down the freeway, flying. It's cruising down, convertible, Corvette, flying down, red Corvette. All of a sudden, the car just completely putters out, pulls to the side of the road. He's like, son of a bitch, I wonder what happened to my car. He sees there's a service station, so he ends up pushing the car over to the service station. He gets out, the mechanic comes up and says, what happened to your car? He's like, I don't know. It just stopped working. It completely just fucking puttered out. I was flying down the freeway. It stopped. So I'll tell you what. There's a little fish and chips place up the street. Why don't you go have something for about an hour, come back. I'll tell you what's wrong with your car. Penguin goes up. He sits down at the booth at the fish and chips place. He eats some fish and chips. Waddles back down to the mechanic. And he says, so, what's wrong with my car? The mechanic says, well, apparently you blew a seal. So the penguin says, no, that's just tartar sauce.
That's a great joke. That's a great joke. However, it need not be a volume from the fucking Encyclopedia Britannica. But you did good.
It was too short otherwise.
No, that's a great joke. Penguin jokes are funny.
That's a face full.
Penguin jokes. That was absolutely perfect. Right. Absolutely perfect. You know the two drunks in Alaska? And they go to a convent. And they go up to Mother Superior. Hey, lady, you got any midget nuns? She says, no. He says, I told you fucked a penguin. A penguin walks into a police booth and says to the sergeant, you got to help me find my husband. And the sergeant says, what's he look like? This is fucking funny. That's just funny. Here we go. Here's Mickey from 90210. But for you, 90210-9990. Jewish James Bond, 00695. No more Jew jokes. Few more Jew jokes. You want to hear a great Jew joke?
Yeah. I would love to hear one.
There's a minister and a Catholic priest and a rabbi playing golf. And the foursome in front of him is really slow. And they're complaining. Finally, the caddy says, fellas, the reason that the foursome in front of us is so slow is they're all blind. And the minister says, that's wonderful that they're handicapped like that, but yet have the spirit to play. And the Catholic priest says, the Lord didn't give them sight, but wanted them to be happy, so made it so they wanted to go out and play the game anyway. And the rabbi says, they couldn't play at night? The rabbi, 40 years he's at the same temple. So to celebrate, they send him to the islands. They send him on a fancy trip, best hotel in Dubai, unbelievable, 25th floor, looking out on the ocean. He walks in his room. There's a 25-year-old girl, naked except for panties, lying there in his bed. And he calls the congregation, what are you doing? 40 years, I'm a rabbi, I take care of you, I'm a holy man, you have a woman in my bed when I get here, and he hangs up the phone. He turns around, the girl's getting dressed. He says, where are you going? I'm not meeting you. Here's Mickey. And then we're going to bring the jogger up here for another look at those chests. Where is she?
It's right there.
I see them. Here we go.
All right. A cop pulls a guy over and says, yo, Mac, have you been drinking? The guy says, why? Is there a big fat pig sitting next to me? Hey,
couple. Hold on.
It is.
Did I fuck that up?
But you are. Yeah, it,
I is.
It, no, why? Not I is.
I is. I is.
No, it's a stammer. Like, it is. A cop pulls a guy over and says, Nick, have you been drinking? And he says, why? Is there a big fat pig sitting next to me? See, it's the thing about me.
He gets a do-over.
No, not with this joke. Why'd you pick this one? It was a great punchline. You're all fucking idiots. Hold on, we got tons.
Here. Oh, shit.
We got to, oh, here's a disgusting one. Oh, there's two. Yeah, no, no, you would do this one. Nice and quiet. No. Now read the punchline first to yourself. Okay. What are you studying?
Is this you not, only read the punchline first.
No,
I'm not fucking this up.
It's not the SATs.
All right, a guy goes into an alley with a hooker, kneels down, pulls down her pants, starts to eat her. And there's peas and carrots and chewed meat in there. He says, lady, are you sick? She says, no, but I think the guy before you might be. All right,
sit down, Mickey. Give him a round of applause. Good job, good job, good job. Melrose Place. Who's got a joke? All right, Cameron, it's your turn. Cameron, we're not going to say the camera's on. Here we go. Don't touch the mic.
Okay.
Here we go. Hold on. You look inspired.
Okay.
Quiet.
So it came out in the news recently that Magic Johnson likes to have sex with ears. But he can only have sex with deaf girls because they already have hearing aids.
Oh!
You want to read? Hey, we'll let you read one. Here, we'll let you read one. Here. Okay, anybody can get a laugh with this joke. Anybody. Quiet, everybody.
Dirty Johnny's in the bathroom taking a leak when his mother steps out of the shower. He points between her legs and says, what's that? She says, that's where an Indian hit me with his tomahawk. He says, ouch, right in the snatch, eh?
A classic! Sit the fuck down. Okay.
Follow Brunelli's joke.
The witch?
The Brunelli's joke. The story.
Somebody tried to stump me with a joke here the other night, and it's a pretty obscure joke. And it's very funny, but I'm not going to tell you a joke yet because it's part of the story. I had a thing, a little plastic box that had a tape that whirred around, and it was rigged so if you push the nose, it tell a joke and then stop. You push the nose, tell another joke and stop. It's a great thing. I did it with George Schlatter, who produced Laughing 100,000 years ago. It's a great little gadget. I gave them out to everybody. Some of them lasted 5 seconds. Some of the people still have them on their desks. So I was friends with Grillo. He was tending bar at a place on York and First named Brunelli, a nice Italian restaurant. The guy that owned it, the front guy, was this guy, Russ Brunelli, big bruiser of a guy, real nice guy, great food, and every Tuesday, Wednesday night, people get up and sing, you know, the whole regular cast of characters, you know, with Tony Bennett's daughter, you know, everybody, all the Ginzos, anybody, oh, everybody flocks there. So it was a really fun place. And Russ was crazy. He really liked to get drunk and play the harmonica. Now, there's a thing, if you own a bar, and there's some other people that own a bar, if they come into your bar, it's like a rule of thumb. It doesn't matter what time it is you serve them. Even if everybody else is gone, if the other fellow bar owners come in, you got to serve them. It's just something that they do. So it's late one night, and he's got one of these joke machines that, at random, just like the show tonight, you don't know what's coming up. You don't know what's going to be next. So four or five Irish guys from two bars away are drunk already. Russ's place is closed and everybody's gone. And they walk in, Brunelli, give us a drink. Come on, drinks. And they sit down in a round table and the big plate glass window is right there. Come on, give us a drink. And Russ He's a nice guy, he's cleaning up, and he brings them over a drink. Come on, get us another drink, Brunelli. Get it. So they're fucking with him. You know, get us another. So they're running them. And he's getting drinks because he's being a nice guy. And these guys are loaded. They were loaded when they got there, and they're getting drunker and drunker. Well, they're Irish guys. The next thing you know, one of them's like, stop picking on us. You don't need more. You, fuck you. And next thing you know, these guys, half of them are brothers, but they're ready. He knows any second is going to be a full-scale brawl. And if these Irish guys are going to beat the shit out of each other, there's going to be a chair goes through the plate glass window. His place is going to be destroyed. And 2 minutes later, these Irish guys are going to be hugging each other, kissing each other, telling each other how much they love each other, and leave. And his place is going to be a mess. He doesn't know what to do. So these guys, and they're right this close to going nuts. He doesn't know what to do. He gets the little box, okay, the little joke in the box, and just comes over and puts it down in the middle of the table and pushes the nose. And the joke that came up is, what's the difference between Neil Armstrong and Michael Jackson? Neil Armstrong is the first guy to walk on the moon, and Michael Jackson likes to fuck little boys in the ass. From Pluto. They're like, what the fuck? And Russ hits it again. And the next joke, before the next joke was hardly even started, they're laughing. They completely forgot that they were about to fight and it saved the fucking day. So, and then Russ gets so excited. It's a great story. But the caveat to the story is, if he had done that and pushed the nose and it had been an Irish joke, his place would have been wrecked and they would have been picking up the pieces. But that's Grillo's joke. Give him a round of applause. Oh, that little box was just a hoot, just a hoot. Every filthy, disgusting, wonderful, terrific. All right, I'm gonna play. You cocksuckers don't want to play. I'm gonna play.
Oh, dumb.
Old Faithful.
Okay, I was in a Corvette. Sorry.
Why did God invent women?
Why?
To carry the semen from the bedroom to the toilet. Girl's 40 years old. Mother says, Harriet, you gotta get married. Leave me alone, Ma. You gotta get married, Harriet, you're 40 years old. Leave me alone, Ma. Every night, Harriet, 40 years old. Ma, leave me alone. Leave me alone, Ma. Leave me alone. One night, Harriet walks in. She got rice in her hair. Her mother says, you did it! You got married! She says, no, I was blowing a chink. He threw up in my head. They don't throw rice anymore. You know, there's jokes you can't use because they go out. I mean, I was doing a show, and it was even years ago. I was doing a show, and there was some older folks sitting there, and they're looking up at me laughing because they're counting the amount of things that people are, you know, like. Most of the night, I talk about Alan Funt and Liberace, and they're like, they don't know what the fuck you're talking about. There's a joke that has like five things in it that don't exist anymore, but it was my favorite joke. It's just the greatest joke. He can't use it. Little old Mr. Ravelli's on his front stoop, barbecuing a chicken on a manual rotisserie. And a beatnik comes walking by and says, hey man, the music stopped and your monkey's on fire. Beatnik, rotisserie, organ grinder, monkey. Fuck you. All Indians. We can open the umbrella. People of color, but not that color. An Iranian woman's in the supermarket. And she picks up two potatoes. She says, these remind me of my husband's testicle. Another woman says, that big? She says, no, that dirty.
Oh,
You know the significance of that little red dot in the middle of an Inuman's forehead? That means coffee's ready. My favorite story, this is for you, Joanne. This is, it's a true story. This was told to me by an incredible actor named Stephen Lang, who's like one of the great New York stage actors. And he was in some movie, I was in Toronto Film Festival, and we're at some film party, and he comes up and says, all right, joke man, I'm gonna tell you a story. I said, okay. It's like, here we go, Jesus, tell me your story. And I almost had a heart attack. Dwarfs are drunks, they're angry, and they're horny. Drunk, horny, and angry. There was a dwarf named Michael Dunn in the 50s. He was in a TV, early 60s, a TV show called Wild Wild West, and he was like the sidekick. But he's a famous actor, great, great dwarf actor. There was a very famous movie called Ship of Fools, which was about a bunch of Jews, and they wouldn't let them bring the boat in because it was full of Jews and it was wartime. It's all sad, crazy story, but the entire movie, it's black and white movies, oh, heart-wrenching. And it's narrated by Michael Dunn. And he's like, you know, the on the thing of the ship, the railing, he's this little, hey, here we are on the ship, you know, so. It wins the lead prize at the Cannes Film Festival in like 1964, 65. It's a big deal. Everybody's a huge party afterwards. So Michael Dunn's at the party. He's the star of the movie. He's drunk and he's horny and he's angry. And if you've ever been to, you don't even have to go to Cannes. Just imagine a film celebration. But this is the winner of a film festival. And it's the Cannes Film Festival. The woman, you get a headache. It's unbelievable. And Claudia Cardinale was a statuesque Italian actress, like Marilyn Monroe or Jane Mansfield, but the Italian version. And she was tall and slender with a skirt up to here with the slits, and she had earrings and jewelry and just reeking of perfume and low cut, she's just dripping of sex. And Michael Dunn's staring at her. And he's, for hours, he's at the party, he's just staring at her. Finally, he walks up to her. And he says, Claudia, I'm gonna fuck you. She looks down, she says, Michael is done. If you do, and I find out about it. That's a beauty, that's a beauty. Where were we? Midget, we're on midgets. Enough midgets. Midget goes to the whorehouse, goes upstairs with a girl, takes down his pants, he has a 2-foot cock. She says, bullshit, you're not putting that thing in me. I'll kiss it. He says, fuck you, I can do that myself. And then, this has been going around, but this is the best in a million years. A guy smashed in a car in front of him. The other driver gets out, it's a dwarf. The dwarf walks over, looks at the damage, comes over the guy's window, he says, I'm not happy. The guy says, well, then which one are you? $15 if you got a joke on this topic. $15. Drunk joke. Alex has a drunk joke. Okay. Is it? Oh, it's Harry with the one line. Go. You're not getting $15. Go ahead. Go ahead.
What happened to the politician? He's still
there. Nobody voted for him.
Good. Here's John DeBellis. Go ahead.
I went to an Irish AA meeting. It's a 2-drink minimum. I've actually learned to hold my liquor. I throw up my hands.
So you know what's your mom?
Rodney.
Tell them!
What's your favorite Rodney?
Rodney joke.
Go ahead,
Rodney. I remember you, we were catch a rising star when we were outside in the bar room. Rodney comes up to us and he said, "Okay, what's the worst thing about oral sex?" He said, "I don't know. The view."
One more, go ahead.
He said, "I went to a gay bar the other day. There were four guys to every guy."
That was good.
You do Rodney. You do Rodney.
No, I'm not doing Rodney.
You come on, new great
story. No, next week. Give yourselves a round of applause. I am going to wind up the show with three disgraceful jokes. Before I do that, Joanne, would you like to come up and read a joke?
Yeah.
Come on, honey. This is my friend Joanne from Oyster Bay. Beautiful girl. This is a nice clean joke for you.
Oh boy.
Right into the microphone. Right, here you go. Step right up. Right up to the microphone, Joe. Yeah. Go ahead.
Three guys and a girl.
But take your time, nice and slow. You hold it here. Move close to the microphone. Okay.
Three guys and a girl are marooned on a desert island. After 1 week, the girl is so ashamed of what she's doing, she kills herself. After another week, the guys are so ashamed of what they're doing, they bury her. After another week, they're so ashamed of what they're doing, they dig her up again.
Good job. I'm giving you $5. Here you go. Two disgusting jokes. Go away. I love you. Oh, no. Oh, I'd fuck it so hard I'd hurt you. This is a joke you can take home. This is very horrible. Kid says, "Pop, what's a vagina look like?" "So, well, son, before sex, a vagina is like a rose with soft, pink, velvety petals and the aroma of perfume. What about after sex? You ever see a bulldog eating mayonnaise?" This is the good night joke, but first, I have a job to do. "Could you turn up the heat?"
What happened?
Cab driver picks up a nun. He looks in the rear of his mirror. He says, "You know, sister, I always fantasize about being with a nun." She says, "Yeah, you and everybody else. You Catholic?" "Yes, I am." He says, "Pull over." He pulls over. She gets to the front, gives him the best blowjob he's ever had. She gets done. He feels a little guilty. She says, "Sister, I'm not really Catholic." She says, "Yeah, my name's Ralph. I'm going to a costume party." I hope you had a great time in here. Thank you. Please be good to Alex. The sexiest waitress we can get. Please be good to Alex, because when the show's over, he wants to go buy some coke. He's got some kids in college, so. Thanks to DeBellis, Joanne, all you guys. I'm going to take your picture and post it into everything. Good night, everybody. Thank you.